Hello, everyone. Thank you very much for your kind attention to my English-Japanese broadcast from Japan. Today's Wednesday, the 23rd of September 2020 at 9:30 p.m. in local time. Today's YY News Live is the 3,081st broadcast in total. My name is Yasuhiko Yamazaki. I am a Japanese independent journalist based on internet media. I'm also a political and social activist. I'm broadcasting every day in Japanese YY News Live, except Saturday and Sunday at 9 p.m. in local time for more than 7 years. Approximately 1,000 persons are watching each time. I started English-Japanese broadcast bi-weekly on Wednesday night from the 7th of February 2016 in order to talk directly to 1.4 billions of English speakers around the world to let them know the hidden and unknown truths on Japan and the world. The principal subject of today: at what stage of capitalism are we living now? Number one, we live in the seventh stage of the capitalism, super financial capitalism. Marx and Engels once argued that if the working class overthrows the capitalist class, abandons private property and carries out a communist revolution, then capitalism will be followed by a utopia equals communist era without capitalist rule and exploitation. But this was wrong. This is because the Soviet Union, Eastern European socialist countries, China, and North Korea that achieved the communist revolution came to the one-party dictatorship by communist party executives who monopolized abandoned private property, not the utopia. As long as human beings cannot survive without depending on material equals capital, the capitalism would continue forever, and it is each stage of the capitalism that would change. Each stage of capitalism: 1. First stage, collection and hunting economy, self-sufficiency and barter economy by collection and hunting. 2. Second stage, primitive agricultural economy, a society of self-sufficiency and barter economy by agriculture, where money, such as bronze coins, has begun to circulate. 3. Third stage, agricultural capitalist, the feudal lord monopolized the land and ruled the peasants. Dual rule of absolute monarchy, of secular power and Vatican papal power, the priesthood was established in each European country. The gold jeweler started the money lending business based on the gold of others kept in their safe. Money lender certificate has begun to be distributed as banknote in the market. 4. Fourth stage, commercial capitalism, the merchants who emerged from the development of the agricultural capitalist economy dominated the production and distribution of goods, expanded consumption and realized the accumulation of commercial capital. The gold jeweler changed from the money lender business to the banker, and the money lender certificate became a banknote and was distributed to the market. In 1694, the world's first bank, the Bank of England, was established. 5. Fifth stage, industrial capitalism, the amount of banknote money produced by the bank credit creation has increased sharply. Banknote money was mainly invested in the industrial development and expansion, and realized a dramatic expansion of the real economy. This is the Industrial Revolution. 6. Sixth stage, financial capitalism, the banknote money produced by the bank credit creation increased sharply, creating a huge amount of the speculative money, and the speculative money economy surpassed the real economy. However, the gold standard system limited the economic scale of the speculative money economy and the real economy by the total amount of the gold. The Rothschild family of Europe ruled the Bank of England in 1815, and in 1913 established the central bank equals the Federal Reserve System, FRB, in the United States to gain U.S. currency issuance and control. 7. Seventh stage, super financial capitalism, this is the stage of capitalism in which we live. In 1971, U.S. President Nixon suddenly announced stopping the conversion of dollars and gold. Due to the so-called Nixon shock, the economic scales of the speculative money economy and the real economy are no longer supported by the gold and can be infinitely expanded. After that, the central banks of each country controlled by the Rothschild International Financial Mafia reprinted a large amount of the bank money without being limited by the stock of the gold and without being interfered by the government, and created a huge speculative money market and financial economy expanded to dozens of times the scale of the real economy. Furthermore, their basic structure of world and nations' rule and exploitation is cleverly hidden, so most ordinary people remain unaware of its identity. Number 1 and